everyone, and welcome back to Danganronpa V3, Killing Harmony.
If you haven't watched the previous three episodes, go ahead and watch those before jumping into part four, this video. Because you miss a lot of good stuff. So yes, let's jump right on in where we left off. We actually discovered that we are inside of a dome or cage of some sort. Yeah, we're like inside of a very giant wall all surrounding us. I can't look like all the way up, but you get the idea. And there's a smaller cage over there. Oh, here's the dormitories. Oh, hey. Oh, there's a sign. Whoa, okay, I'm very fast all of a sudden. Dolphins. Over there, nice. But it's blocked off. Crap. Okay, coffee shop. I don't see a building over there, but I'll take your word for it. And what's over here? What's over here? I'm guessing that's a bed for dormitory. Nice. Alright, well, I spy a little someone here, so let's actually talk to him. Who are you, my good friend? Jeez, how'd they even make this big-ass wall? Seriously, I just don't get it.
Hey.
I wonder what will happen now. If we can't escape, then...
Hey.
What? Are you complaining?
Huh?
Huh?
Listen up.
Quit complaining and grumbling, or it'll turn into a habit.
Yeah.
Besides, this cage is nothing compared to the vastness of the universe! Huh? The universe?
Got it.
Whoops, I haven't introduced myself yet. My bad.
I'm Kaito Momota, Luminary of the Stars. Even crying children adore the ultimate astronaut.
The ultimate astronaut. Alright, I can get behind that, sure. Cool. Huh. How about it? I'm an astronaut. Isn't that cool? Yeah. I've never been to space, so I don't know much about it. Well, of course. Not just anyone can get up there. I may be an astronaut, but I'm actually still in training.
I see.
Oh, I see. So you're still a trainee.
But you know.
But I'm the first teenager to ever pass the exam. I mean, normally you need a college degree to even take the exam.
Huh?
Huh? Then how did you take the exam?
So...
I had a friend who was pretty crafty. So I had him forward some stuff for me.
Jeez.
Oh, that's illegal.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ended up getting caught. I was in pretty deep shit! But the people up top decided they liked me, and well, they let me in anyway. Of course I aced the exam too.
Jeez.
That's reckless.
Got it.
Sometimes you gotta be a little reckless to make your dreams a reality. Make your dreams come true! Just do it! Okay, I'm done. No way I can wait till after college. Sorry, Lubov. I wanna get to space as fast as I can.
But...
Why is that? You sure have a lot of energy.
Got it.
Yeah, let's call it that, energy. Yeah, everyone told me it was impossible, but I never gave up. Not for a moment.
Better believe it! Naruto, yeah!
Okay. References up the yin-yang. That's because limits don't exist unless you set them yourself. Good point. There are no walls you can't get over. The same goes for that one.
Could it be...
So, do you have any ideas? Nope.
Shut up!
That's not the problem! No, that is the problem. Jeez, this guy sure talks a big game. Yeah, and he can't back it up either. Alright, well, we still got a friendship fragment. Yep. Kaito. Okay, cool. Nice to meet you, dude. Anywhere, anybody. I don't know if I should be... I don't know if I should be going into any buildings just yet. Because I don't know if that'll trigger certain events. So let's actually wander around the streets or sidewalk? Whatever. Oh, wow, we can go up. Okay. No one here. Damn. No one over here. Oh no. Damn. I was wondering if we could actually walk into the grassy area. Guess not. Okay, anyone down here? Wait, whoa. Oh, I see someone. Hello, you're a little big guy, aren't you? Okay, well, where are we? I mean, I know we're still outside of the... What the hell? Oh my god, we traveled. Okay. Anyway, who are you? Hello.
Whoa, this guy looks scary. He's so big and muscular. Excuse me? Hmm?
Thank you!
Oh, thank you!
Huh?
Huh? Thank you.
Sorry?
Oh, sorry for scaring. Got that scary looking. Most people not want to talk to Gonta when meeting for first time.
Cause Gonta gentleman.
So, like gentlemen, Gonta say thank you. Thank you for talking to Gonta.
Yeah.
Thank you for being so polite? You look scary, but he doesn't seem very scary at all.
Oh!
Oh, right. Gonta need to make introduction.
Gonta's name is Gonta Gokuhara. Gonta's talent is ultimate entomologist.
Entomologist?
Gonta want to become gentleman. Becoming true gentleman, Gonta's goal.
Alright, I can get behind that too. Nice. Nice meeting you. That's a really cute name. Really? Thank you. You're actually pretty nice. Silly me for being so scared at first.
Maybe.
Oh, Gonta scary looking, huh?
Sorry.
Oh, sorry. That's not why I...
No.
No. It's okay. Gonta used to it. Gonta called scary since he was a kid. Since you were a kid? Huh?
Oh, Gonta see.
Kid Gonta bigger than other kids. Other kids scared of Gonta. So Kid Gonta, play along. It's worded weird, as you can obviously tell, so it's a little hard for me to keep up. I want to speak normally, but this is... Yeah, anyway. That how Gonta come to like bugs. But when Gonta really focus, it's easy to lose track. Oh god, I keep being paused. One day, Gonta go to forest to find bugs. End up lost.
I see.
That sounds rough. Were they able to find you right away? Mm. Yeah. Look, 10 years though.
Huh?
What? 10 years? Oh, what? What? Who? What? 10 years? What?
But
Gonta fine. New family took care of Gonta.
Hmm.
Oh my lord, 10 years? What the hell? How did you survive that, man? Man, you really are George of the Jungle and Tarzan all combined together. Anyway, I see. I'm glad they were nice people. Oh, not people, wolves. Are you kidding me now? Mr. Wolfman here. Instead of fucking apes and gorillas, it's fucking wolves. Goddamn Tarzan Yip Yang here.
Huh?
But they really nice. Yeah, right. Cause of forest family, Gonta learned to speak bug and animal.
Gonta.
As thanks, Gonta want to show forest family what great gentleman Gonta is. How is becoming a gentleman going to thank them for that? This place strange, huh? Lots of plants, but no bugs.
Huh?
Wait, really? I suppose it's understandable, but there are no animals? I suppose it's understandable that there are no animals, but no insects? That's strange. Not even one bug?
I mean...
You like bugs too?
Amazing!
Hey! What your favorite bug? What do you like about them? Oh my god, his face! It terrifies me. I'm gonna have nightmares. Okay. No, I wasn't saying that I like bugs or anything.
Wait.
Then, you hate bugs?
Huh?
Whoa, what?
But how?
You hate bugs?
That's not true.
Me personally, yes, I'm terrified of them. You don't hate bugs. You love them, right, Shuichi?
Okay.
Yeah, of course I do. I love bugs.
Thank goodness.
Oh. Okay, that good. No bad person likes bugs. Wait, what? Okay. Yeah, I got it. It's okay. Oh god, don't murder me. Don't murder me, please. I'm friendly. I love bugs. Not really. That was scary. Whew, yeah, I thought you were gonna die. Honestly, I can't stand bugs either, but it might be best to hide that. Yeah, I don't want him going on a
murderous rampage. I still think you're a good guy, just not when it comes to people hating bugs. Okay. Anyway.
What the fuck are you? Hi? Is this a ninja statue?
Right.
It looks like one. But why is this here? Seriously, there are so many odd things. Yeah, seriously. Alright, well hopefully we get answers to that soon. That's blocked off. What's this? What is this giant-ass cage inside of another giant-ass cage that is surrounding us? Ooh, a little waterfall. Oh, hello. I remember you from the demo. Yes. All right, let's talk.
Yahoo!
How are ya?
My name is Angie Yonaga. I'm the ultimate artist.
Ultimate artist.
Cool. Oh, look at these, so cute. Okay.
You're pretty cheerful. She's a bit too happy considering the situation we're in right now. There's no reason to carry bad thoughts with ya. You gotta live every day like it's bright, cheery, and fun.
Cause Ato says so.
Ato? Who's Ato?
The god of my island, Ato, is always with me, speaking to me with his divine voice.
Ah, well, she's certainly devout. Do you specialize in painting or sculpting?
I do both. I paint paintings and I sculpt sculptures.
Well, that is the general idea.
But Ato's the one who makes the art. I merely offer my body as his vessel.
So divine!
How divine!
I see.
I see. That's interesting. If you don't mind, can you show me some of your artwork?
Of course, of course!
In return, will you make an offering?
An offering?
Every Monday and Wednesday morning on my island, a truck comes to collect offerings.
That sounds oddly similar to putting out the trash for pickup.
But...
Don't worry. When I say offering, I just mean a pint or two of your blood.
Backing the fuck up. Kaede, back up. That's dangerous. No touchy. No. Don't worry. I'm a bit anemic, so I'll pass.
I see.
What about you then?
Huh? Me?
Yep.
Poi's blood is also an acceptable offering.
Come on.
It won't hurt one bit.
Wait a minute.
Don't run away! this girl is so weird.
Oh, okay. I like her. A little weird. With the blood and atoll situation. But anyway, interesting. Okay. Monitor. Get those level ups. Anything else to point out except for the waterfall, but nope, that's not even showing up. Okay, anything else on the ground? Nope. Anything over here? Nope. Alright, we're leaving. I still had that thing on, the observe function. Is it still gonna be on? No, because it just brings up no.
Okay, cool.
So that's everyone here so far. Was there another way up there? I think there was. Yeah, there was. Let's return back then. And I think there's a couple more people we're actually missing here. So let's find them, shall we? I don't know if they're going to be in the dormitory, but let's go this way first and find out some stuff. Okay. Anyone over here? Oh, damn. That sucks. Okay, dining hall. Ooh, there's a dining hall. Nice. Alright, let's go in. Can we? It looks like I can enter the school building from here, but it's blocked off. Damn. Alright, well, the only place left is the dormitory. Let's go in, shall we? Huh. I'm actually liking this so far. It's pretty neat. And I love the characters. Some of them, anyway. Alright, I think there should be one or two characters left that we have not met. Right? No, only one? This building is round and has a lot of smaller rooms inside.
Very nice to see you again.
Son of a bitch, would you go away?
Nice to see you again.
Well, hello, Bear.
We're intruding.
Sorry to intrude.
Please.
What is it this time? What do you mean by intruding?
What the hell you saying?
Because this is your home, you bastards. We finished setting up the showers. Now you can go pee.
Hey.
What? Why? What?
Why don't they just use the toilets? Huh? Even for number two?
Ah.
No. Oh, God. Wait, do you go number two? No!
That's gross. Thank you, Monofunny. Oh, God. That's gross. Please go away. Yes. Oh, that was short visited. Thank you. What do you mean, our home?
Could it be...
They mean for us to live here? See, there are 16 doors. Perhaps a room for each of us.
Stop it.
I don't plan on staying here long enough to need a room. Well, sorry, babe, but there's no exit. You're gonna have to stay here. Alright. You're the only one left, I see.
I fail to see their objective.
Huh? What do you mean?
If they are holding us for ransom, a large facility such as this would be unnecessary. Furthermore, I gather they would rather care for us than hurt us. In light of this, I fail to see the true objective of the culprits reasonable for kidnapping us.
Culprits, huh?
I never even thought about that. Why would our kidnappers go to all this trouble? 16 ultimate students have been gathered here, but why? What's the reason?
Excuse me.
Pardon me. I have not introduced myself yet.
I am Kirumi Tojo, the ultimate maid.
Ultimate maid?
Please let me know if you require my service.
Will do. Wink.
Alright. Liking her style already. Nice little outfit. Along with a little pattern of spider web on her... on her breast. Okay, anyway.
Wow, the ultimate maid sounds like a really cool talent. Really? Not cool, handy, but if you say so, Kaede. Ah, wait, I've heard of Kurumi Tojo. I think I butchered the name, but oh well.
An ultimate with incredible intellect and strength, working as a private maid. I heard that her work is so perfect, she can complete any request given to her.
Huh?
What? She's that amazing?
I do not agree.
Please, you are exaggerating. I do not complete any request that is asked of me. I once received a request to annihilate a rival nation, but as it was impossible, I rejected it.
You seriously got requested to annihilate a whole fucking nation? What?
Oh, fucking crazy, okay. But being requested to do that is pretty impressive on its own.
That's true.
I've also heard that she's been hired as a bodyguard to several foreign dignitaries.
I do not agree.
I have only been employed as a maid, not a bodyguard.
I see.
But you've been hired by so many different people. You're like a super maid.
May I?
Moving on, what do you intend to do now?
That's a tough question. What should we do? What would you do, Kurumi?
I do not agree.
I hold no opinions or desires of which to speak.
I am a maid, after all.
As a maid, my only desire is to fulfill the desires of others. So please, think about what you desire for yourself and what you desire from me.
For everyone.
No matter the situation, no matter what happens, I am here to serve everyone. Even in this situation, she's more concerned for others.
Well, she is the ultimate maid, after all.
Ooh, okay, cool. I got a feeling she's gonna help someone in the killing. Okay, that's gonna be nice.
Assistant! Oh, yep, we have met everyone! Alright!
Huh?
Was that the bell?
Oh. Kaede, look, the monitor!
Ooh, hello.
Thanks for bearing with us!
You bastards!
Kept your bastards waiting, huh?
All right!
Everyone, make your way to the gym, please. The opening ceremony can finally begin.
Phew.
Whew. We've finally finished our preparations.
Do you realize you just read your lines backwards, don't you?
So long,
Farewell!
Even I fucked up a little bit, but oh well. Jim, opening ceremony.
Hey.
Yeah, you're gonna meet their father, and I'm putting air quotes on father. Anyway, Kaede, what should we do? What should we do? Go, of course. Everyone else is probably doing the same thing.
You're right.
True, but I'm a little worried about this. Well, I'm not a little worried. I'm very, very worried. Alright, I guess we can go. Sure. So we have to go to the gym. I think I remember where that is. If I can get moving. Yay, I move! Run! Oh god, that was fast! Run along! Gym is this way, if I remember correctly. But I don't remember which floor. Is it floor 1 or floor 2? Yeah, it's floor 1. Yeah. Yeah. At the end of the hallway section, whatever that's supposed to mean. Still nothing there. That's okay. That's not the gym. The gym is right over here. Ta-da! The gym! Alright. I'm actually going to go ahead and save real quick. You never know what might happen. There we go. Alright. Enter gym. Okay. Here is everyone.
Do you agree?
All 16 of us have gathered. It's pretty spectacular seeing all 16 of us Ultimates gathered together.
You may not be able to be so easygoing for much longer. In this situation, it's no use thinking about things, so eventually, Tsumugi stopped thinking. Yeah, what's gonna happen to us? I bet it'll be a big pain.
What?
What are you looking at?
Himiko!
Himiko? You can use amazing powers, right? Cause you're a psychic and stuff, right?
It's magic.
I'm not a psychic. I'm a mage. Wow! That's amazing! I definitely want to incorporate that into Neo Aikido.
What?
Hey, what sort of training did you undergo to gain your awesome powers? Talking about it is so tiring.
You're pretty lazy.
Please wait.
Pardon me, but we need to be on our guard. We do not know if and when danger will strike.
Please don't.
Don't say that. I'm so scared. I don't know what to do.
It'll be okay.
There's no need to worry. Atoll will protect us.
Thank goodness.
Whew, oh god, you. That better not be your, like, love-struck face or something. Back off! Whew, that's a relief.
Fucking moron!
Oh, the vulgar. Okay.
Is their brain full of weeds or something? I'll whack him out that skull of yours.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. Just leave it to me.
Leave it to me.
If those teddy bears show themselves again, I'll kick all their asses.
Gonto wonder.
Huh?
What that?
What's wrong?
What's wrong?
See?
Listen. Hear that? Yeah, I do.
Ah, I think I hear it. It sounded like an engine from a robot enemy.
You bastard! You just had to mention it, didn't you? These little shits.
Everyone!
Behind Gonta!
What?
Whoa, what the what? What are these? What the heck are these monsters?
Wow!
Wow, so cool!
Hell yeah!
They're accessals! Highly mobile, bipedal weapon platforms. They get lots of hometown pride too.
What are you saying?
I can't keep track of these backstories. Whatever they are, they better kill off the Yugos and save me for last.
Hey!
Run, Himiko! Why are you concerned about me all of a sudden?
By the way.
Hmm? Didn't someone say they would kick all their asses? Oh, what the hell? Nobody told me about these.
It's okay.
Alright, chill out. No need to panic. We're probably not in any danger. If they wanted to kill us, they'd have done it by now. With that, Rantaro casually walked up to the Exosols.
Then...
So, what do you want from us? You clearly want something. That's what you got in... That's what the guns are for, right? Let me guess. You're gonna force us to do something, and if we don't, we get hurt.
That means...
Well, you have our attention. So, what do you want?
And that's that.
Huh. Well, aren't you a wise guy?
Hey!
I'll start us off. Listen up. Here's what we want you punk asses to do. My heart's going 100 miles per hour. I'm gonna say it. You ready? Hell yeah! It's a...
Killing game.
Killing game. Oh, Manadam fucking spoke for once. Damn.
Huh?
What?
Manadam! How dare you upstage me?
Huh?
Whoa, wait a second. What did you say?
If I heard him correctly...
It's a killing game.
Oh. He just has a normal robotic voice.
Ah, he said it again! Oh, God. Damn it, Manadam! I'm gonna crush you with this here, Exosol.
Come on! We don't have time to fight amongst ourselves!
Okay!
Yeah, if we don't stop fighting, I'm gonna crush you with this here, Exosol. You too, Montaro.
Leave it to me!
Is this what it's come to? Then I will crush the four of you with this here, Exosol.
What are you saying?
Hey, why are you including me?
Oh well,
it's more appropriate for us to be hostile to each other.
You all need to chill the fuck out.
Who you calling Jabroni? Jabroni?
They're really like fucking brothers. Jesus Christ.
You say Jabroni?
I'll bow down anytime, Jabroni! Check yourself before you wreck yourself!
Manofani, how dare you!
Are they gonna get it on right in front of us?
Don't worry. Atua is watching over us.
In a situation like this, is he just going to watch?
Maybe.
Either way, it's too dangerous. We need to get out of here, or else...
You won't be able to.
Now.
Oh, yes. Ah, oh, hearing that voice, I'm gonna do that voice so good.
What?
I hope.
You gotta knock off this awful fighting!
Actually, he sounds a little different. Wait, what?
Oh, that voice!
Is it me or does it sound different?
Father!
Father! Father, is that you?
Papa Kuma!
Daddy! Huh?
Daddy? Oh, what the? At that moment, the lights in the gymnasium suddenly shut off. Oh, here we go! The usual... The little zoom in! The zoom in! Here we go! Woohoo! Oh my... Fuck you! You and your wing bullshit! Thank you. No wings for you.
God of this new world.
Is that really your voice? If it is, I'm gonna puke. And I'm gonna give you a new voice.
And the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy!
Don't tell me this is actually his voice. Tell me he's like playing the little nice guy and he's like softening his voice right now.
The one! The only! Monokuma! Nice to meet ya! Yay!
Father's here!
Hell yeah!
Another epic entrance from Papa Kuma!
Oh, nice.
Daddy's so cool!
My little cubs!
Your
are all so freaking cute! The only reason I can tolerate your tiresome antics is because you're all so cute! Even when you're...
Wait, what? Breaking the fourth wall.
Even when the prologue is going way too long, I'll allow it because you guys are so cute. In fact, I'm
Whoa.
In fact, the very first prologue ever was only short because you cutie patooties weren't there.
Pops!
Pops, are you mad at us?
Don't be stupid!
Don't be an idiot! I would never get mad at my cute little cubs. He's mad!
But Teddy's so cool, even when he's angry.
That's right.
Pops is from a planet of handsome bears that get cooler as they get angrier.
It's getting interesting.
Super Mario Kart, Super Mario Kart 2, Super...
You're talking about Dragon Ball Z, you bastard. Oh, fuck!
How many times do I gotta say it? I'm not mad! Ah! Father just transformed into a Super Monokuma God! Super Monokuma!
I knew it! They had to do it! They had to.
How is it possible when six Monokumas of pure heart are gathered together?
Oh, fuck off.
It's the power you...
Yes, I've watched the movies.
You really wanna fuck the world's shit up!
A power you only see when the gods themselves do battle.
Like, oh my god.
Anyway,
I'm not mad. In fact, I gotta admit, it's actually proud of you guys. I'm actually proud of you guys. You kids really stand out from the rest of the second generation failures in the world.
No way.
Isn't that a little harsh?
Gotta make it cuter.
Isn't that a little harsh? I'm sure there are some second generation success stories.
Yeah, but...
Oh, God. It's hard doing all fucking, like, 20 voices here. I can't think of any, though. Oh, fuck. You're beating up your own kids. That's nice.
It's because there's none worth remembering. But Father remembers because he knows everything.
Holy shit! That's right, Papa Kuma! You know all kinds of useless crap!
Cause Daddy gets all his alternate facts from the most trusted names in fake news!
Oh my god, they're making fun of everything right now! Yes! Bring it home to Daddy!
I love embracing my children! They're so cute, I just can't help myself! Usually, ratings will plummet when mascots appear in sequels too much. But in this case, ratings are through the roof. All thanks to the cute bunny cubs.
What is this? What's going on?
Seems like...
Another teddy bear appeared.
No.
Yes, but that is no ordinary teddy bear. I can see it. The despair and madness swirling around that cursed thing.
You're really bugging.
Whoa. First of all, I'm no teddy bear. I'm Monokuma.
That's his angry voice I'm doing, by the way.
And show some respect, I'm the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles.
Huh? Headmaster? Mm-hmm. It appears to be some sort of anonymous robot with a built-in AI like me.
Dong, dong, dong.
Dong, dong, dong.
Yeah, but...
The exosouls are different, though. They're brainless buckets of bolts.
That's right!
They're mindless, pretty killing machines that can only be controlled by us, the Monokubs.
Sheesh.
Anonymous robots piling weapons platforms. This is certainly turning into quite the story, and I did the wrong voice for the fucker. Fucking Christ! God damn it! Actually. So many voices! Breaking down. It's cool. Calm down. Calm down. Okay. Well, that may be, but what I'm worried about is this killing game you mentioned. What exactly does that mean?
How?
What is so amusing?
It's just, when I said it before, I kind of just voted in, and now I feel awkward.
Extreme!
I want you students with your ultimate level talents to participate in a killing game.
Huh? Killing game? Us?
Please stop.
Please stop joking. Why would we agree to participate in a killing game?
Huh?
Huh? You guys don't want to do it.
Gota never do that.
Of course not. Gentlemen not hurt people.
And another thing.
But if you looked around the academy, then you already know, don't you? Their academy is surrounded by a huge wall. You can't escape to the outside world. And as long as we have the XSLs, you can't defy us.
I don't know why I went like deep full. Oh, it could fade. Okay, anyway.
In other words, I hold the power to life of death, of life and death, over each and every one of you.
So ensure.
So do what you say if we don't want to die. Got it.
You gotta be kidding me.
You gotta be kidding me. Why would friends kill each other? Who said you guys were friends?
No way.
You guys aren't friends at all. Your enemy is out to kill each other.
Huh?
Enemies? Well, we're enemies.
I still have a lot to learn from Father about sarcasm. All this talking is bugging the shit out of me! I gotta be up, madam down to relieve stress!
But, I don't like that. I'm not good with violence or gore or sad situations. Daddy, instead of a killing game, could we do a rock, paper, scissors tournament?
You stupid!
Who would want to play a game where no one dies?
I don't know.
Well, you do have a compassionate personality. It's so cute, I can barely stand it.
They're so cute.
Why, it's so cute enough to eat, cute enough that I want to eat it.
Eh?
Hey, Manafani, you might want to dial back the cute shtick a bit.
Yeah, sounded like he was going to eat you literally.
Hey.
Cool it with the stupid banter. I want to ask something. How are we supposed to kill each other? Are you going to give us weapons?
What the hell, man? What are you asking?
But
we need to get info from them first. We can't do anything if we don't know anything.
No way!
Weapons? Huh? What kind of barbaric display are you envisioning? You couldn't be more wrong. Why, at the ultimate... You couldn't be more wrong! Why, at the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles, the killing game is quite the refined, sophisticated experience.
What?
Sophisticated experience?
Yes, here the killing game is punctuated by class trials.
Class trials.
Okie dokie!
Okay, let us explain.
Ooh.
Alright, so if one of you maggots kills someone, you all gotta take part in a class trial.
Oh, relief from my voice, thank you so much, that would help.
The class trial is where the blackened killer faces off against their spotless classmates.
It's where you punk-ass bitches argue over who you fucking think the blackened is. After that, it's voting time!
Voting time!
Majority of you idiots vote correctly.
Yeah.
Then only the blackened killer will receive punishment. So, girl,
oh, what the?
Just imagining...
Don't do that. No.
Makes me want to puke.
Oh, God.
After
get over it.
After the blackened is punished... The rest of yous will just keep right on living together.
Okay.
But if you vote for the wrong person during the class trial...
Uh-oh, what will happen?
The blackened gets off scot-free, and all the spotless students get punished instead.
Oh, no.
Hell yeah! Them's the rules of the class trial! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Oh! Yeah!
What is with that long-ass tongue? Holy fuck! I remember someone with a certain long tongue from the first game. I think the second game too, right? I don't know.
Ah, too much! The explanation revealed way too much! You gotta be more coy, flirtatious, seductive, just like your old man.
Gross.
Yeah, gross.
Hey,
The point is, it's not enough to kill someone. You also have to survive the class trial.
How should I put this?
Kill without being caught, and then survive the trial. Sounds eerily similar to the real world.
You think so? Then the outside world must be masterfully designed. Even at its cruelest.
Listen.
One can likely imagine, but I shall ask, just in case. What is the punishment you mentioned earlier?
Yeah. Simply put, it's an execution!
Huh? Execution?
If you do a crime, you get punished for it. That's like the most basic rule of society. But this is a killing game. So the punishment for murder is a bit more permanent.
You die, son!
Hell yeah!
I wonder what kind of punishments there'll be. Lots of blood and guts and brains, I bet.
The kind of stuff that gives me a raging boner.
Eh? What? What? Mudder, do you already have a boner?
Get a rock hard rager!
Yeah, I'm so hard. What the fuck is going on? What? Blood, guts, brains. Did I hear that right? She literally voiced it.
God, man.
Oh my god.
Whoa! Motherfucker just puked.
Get a rock hard rager!
Oh god. Huh? Puke gives you a boner too?
You kids are so adorable!
What?
Whoa, what the hell's cute about that?
Well now.
Alright. I'm over this boring exposition.
Thrills, chills, kills!
Let's get this heart-pounding killing school semester started already!
You have free reign to murder however you like, too!
Okay.
Like bludgeoning, or stabbing! Feeling cheap? Try strangulation! Feeling lazy? Try poisoning! Whether you shoot, burn, drown, blow up, crash, electrocute, or laugh your victim to death.
Sounds like a fun good old time.
You can use any method you like to kill anybody you like, any way you like.
Yay!
At the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles, you will realize your murderous potential.
I'm really hating his voice right now. It's so different, and it's sounding more and more like he's a fucking twisted Mickey Mouse. And I already know there are already memes of him having already sounded like Mickey Mouse and shit, but now it's like permanently for real. They actually made him almost really sounding like Mickey Mouse, and it's cringy right now. It's so cringy.
16 talented teenage prodigies.
Fuck.
All competing for first place in a killing game.
I don't know how they can. How do they mess up Monokuma and his voice? How?
There's no better setting for an event like this than the Ultimate Academy!
Son of a bitch. Killing school semester, it's like a game.
Risking our lives for some silly game is absurd.
But
it doesn't seem like it'll be a boring, though. Hey, how can you degenerates be so calm?
It can't
this
be.
Has to be a lie, right? It's a lie, right? Unfortunately, not. A lie, more like fiction. Like a story on TV. A scenario so removed from reality, we can hardly believe it's happening.
It's no use.
I don't want to be in a killing game. It's wrong. I never do that.
Well, if you don't want to participate in the killing game, let's Well, that's gonna be a problem. Thought the killing game is the only reason you're here.
Huh? What?
Now then, unleash your talents and have a happy, homicidal, horrific, hilarious killing game.
Oh, jeez.
Whoa, wait, just a minute.
Oh?
Hmm?
Stop it.
No matter what you say, we won't do it.
That's wrong.
We'll never participate in a killing game.
I'll do it.
Whatever you have planned, I'm not gonna let you get away with it. Kaede, you shouldn't just rashly defy that thing.
No,
I welcome her resistance. That kind of defiant spirit is important to the killing game. It's fun to watch the defiant ones eventually snap and get their hands dirty.
What do you mean by that?
Everyone loves that kind of brutality in the death game, especially me. It never gets old. It's so fun and entertaining that I just get unbearably pumped up. Oh, the puns. Plus, as the headmaster, it's my job to force you to do it.
Are we done? Oh. We stood in dumbfounded silence, surrounded by the squealing laughter of Monokuma and his cubs. Everything about this situation was so messed up. An academy surrounded by a giant wall, 16 ultimate students trapped inside, mysterious stuffed bears and deadly weapons, and new friends forced to play some killing game. It all felt like something out of a sadistic work of fiction. A sadistic story, no different from reality itself. And against my will, I was now a character in that story. Yeah. Oh, the intro again. Well, actually, this is the official V3 intro. What we saw earlier was like the prequel games and anime shit. Oh yeah, pump to the jam. Oh, I'm loving it. Nice. Shuichi! Hello.
Gonta, Tenko.
Oh, there you are, Himiko. Where are the others? There we go. AJ, Hoshi, Miyu, Kaito. I'm probably butchering so many names. I don't care though. I'm enjoying this nonetheless. And I hope you all enjoyed the madness of my voice and voices. Oh god, just so many fucking characters. Like, I can't keep up. Oh god damn. I'll get better, guys. Don't worry. My Monokuma was a little bit off, though. A little bit. Or a lot off. Yeah.
Bow bow. Yeah! Danganronpa Killing Harmony!
That was beautiful. Ultimate Revival. End. Okay, cool. New! Obtained present! Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juvenile Badge! Nice. Do you want to save? Why, yes, I do. Thank you. Plot number 6. Slot number 6. Can't you read, boy? No, I cannot. After Monokuma and the Monokums left, an alarm suddenly rang from my monopad. It ran.
Not just from mine, the alarm was going off throughout the whole gym. Which meant everyone else had received a monopad as well. When I took mine out, a message was displayed on the screen. Ultimate Academy e-handbook. Okay. Regulations. Students must live at the Ultimate Academy for the remainder of their foreseeable future. Once a murder takes place, all surviving students must participate in a class trial. If the Blackened is exposed during the class trial, they alone will be executed. If the Blackened is not exposed, all remaining students will be executed. If the Blackened survives the class trial, they will graduate and re-enter the outside world. The Killing Game and class trials will continue until only two surviving students remain. Oh, wow. Wait. Wait, what? That's different from last time. They didn't set a limit. So now, it will continue until only two surviving students remain. Oh, that's interesting. Nice. Okay. Nighttime is from 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. The dining hall and gymnasium are off limits at night. Violence toward Monokuma, the headmaster of the Ultimate Academy, is strictly prohibited. Monokuma will never directly commit a murder. Your monopads are very important items. Please do not damage them. The body discovery announcement will play when three or more students discover a body. With minimal restrictions, you are free to explore the campus at your discretion. Students who violate these rules will be immediately exterminated by the Exosouls. Okay? The headmaster may add new regulations to this list at any time.
You gotta be kidding me.
You cheating motherfucker.
I will never participate in a killing game.
That's what you're saying now. Anyway. That's what they all say. My class trial, our class trial. Chapter 1, Daily Life. Cool. All right. Oh, I can save. Nice. Well, everyone, I'm actually going to leave it here for now so we can actually officially start chapter 1 in the next video. That was a nice prologue. I fucked up a few times. I'm so sorry. I'm going to leave this entirely uncut, I think. Maybe a tiny little edits every now and then because I coughed and shit. Bleh. You don't want to hear me cough, right? But anyway, if you enjoyed, please leave a like, share the video, and subscribe if you would like to see more. I upload daily, and I'm going to be doing this probably every day because, well, there's going to be an announcement video coming up pretty soon to discuss some changes to my channel. So I'll look forward to that as well. So again, thank you for watching, and I hope you all stick around. I'll see you all next time. See you then. Goodbye.